in a better way than in the past, because Allah said, worship me alone and be kind and dutiful to your parents. Number two, the parents, after the command of being true worshiper or a believer. So education does not happen all of a sudden. Can you become a scholar overnight? If you sit with me from now until the morning, 24 hours, will you become a scholar? You only learn the amount which you absorb in this time. For any person to graduate from the medical school and become an MD, you go through a lot. Human, the medical school, the residency, it can take you 10 years to become a practicing MD or a licensed doctor. Same thing. Everything, you have to take it slowly and steady, step by step. The Prophet ﷺ once, his wife Aisha asked him, which deen is best? Which act is best before Allah? He said, the one which is constant and consistent, even if it is a little. So something that is consistent and persistent and permanent, but continuous, is better than something that you do it all of a sudden, then you quit. You do much and you quit. No. Take it gradually, step by step. So I believe the very first and most important challenge that you face is to learn about Islam. Now you learn about belief and what you're supposed to believe in. Next, learn about Islam in depth, and that can be achieved. And I have seen the work of new Muslims much better than those who were born in Islam. One person, an American person, in the medical field, entered once into the Islamic center and said, Sheikh, I envy you. I would like, I'm a new Muslim, I would like to recite the Quran as beautiful as you do. Is it possible that within my lifetime I can do that? I said, as a matter of fact, it's much easier than what you can imagine. But you need to give me some time. He said, but I'm busy, I go to my clinic in the morning at 7 a.m. and I stay there almost for 10 or 12 hours. I said, fine, will you be able to get up half hour earlier and visit with me? Look, this is a professional who is extremely busy, but he was serious. He said, sure I will. So he started getting up before 6 o'clock, 6 a.m. He would come to pray Fajr, or even when the time has changed and the time stayed in summer, that he would come even before Fajr, and we sit only for half hour. In 6 months period of time, he used to sit with us in the halqa and recite Quran better than the Arab who were born in Islam. And when he was ready to move, he gave me a gift that I preserved until today. He memorized most of the juz of Amma, and he wrote it down in his handwriting. It was like the most beautiful piece of art I have seen. He covered exactly the calligraphy of the Quran. Every day had about 6 days a week. In 6 months, he became better than those who were born in Islam in the 40, 50, or 60 years. If there is a will, there is a way. In the beginning of Islam, it depends and it varies from a person to another. There is some person who cannot declare his Islam before his family. I was in Hong Kong before I come, and after a few lectures, several people accepted Islam. In one lecture, 7 of them accepted Islam. 6 Christians and 1 Sikh. So the Sikh person, after the lecture, who stepped out, he came and said, Sheikh, I want to become a Muslim. I said, more than welcome. Let's go ahead. And I said, no, please, for some reason, I don't want to tell my family. Can we do it in private? Yes, we can. As long as he declared the Shahada before witnesses, and as long as he accepted with full conviction, yes, we can. So he said the Shahada. It varies from a person to another. Somebody thinks that Nobody's paying me anything. I'm free to decide for myself. So he has his doubts. Fine. But Omar ibn Khattab, when he accepted Islam first, when people accepted Islam at the time of the Prophet, and even the Prophets, they used to conceal the Iman. They used to hide it. They used to pray in private behind closed doors. But Omar ibn Khattab, when he accepted Islam, he was very powerful. Like, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The American wrestler, the boxer, who accepted Islam and performed Umrah last week, what's his name? Mike Tyson. Mike Tyson is something that before Islam, you could say that this is not a human. In one of the tournaments, he beat his opponent in 3 seconds. In 3 seconds, he finished him off. He ate his ear. We said that this is not a human. He accepted Islam. Umar ibn Khattab was very powerful when he accepted Islam. He went and he declared his Islam before the Meccan chiefs and the powerful guys and the high society said, and by the way, I'm a Muslim. You have any problem with that? Nobody could dare to open his mouth. And when it was time to migrate, he said, people used to migrate secretly. You have seen what happened to Sahaba. Before migrating, Umar ibn Khattab declared to everybody in Mecca, I'm going to migrate to Al-Madinah. If anyone would like his mother to lose him, let him follow me. So it depends on the situation of each and every individual. And that has to be handled with the assistance of the local Muslim community. Nobody accepts Islam, we have to extend the hands of help, of teaching, of even financial support, moral support. Because sometimes people had to lose their families. Their families will boycott them, no matter what's wrong with them. Don't feel sorry. Because you lost a family of 3 or 4 or 5 members, you have the biggest family ever on earth. Every Muslim is your brother or sister. And they love you so much as they love themselves. In addition to, you gain Allah's pleasure and you gain heaven, hopefully. So, take the challenges one by one. Do not keep thinking about all of them like a wood that is about to fall on top of you. And seek the help of your wise brothers and sisters. How to handle this? What does Islam say about that? And I believe the solution to all of those problems and challenges is in being properly educated in your religion. Make dua a lot. As you ask Allah to show you guidance, ask Allah frequently to keep you steadfast and remain strong and deep in faith. Dua is the most powerful means of achieving any good goal. Next question, please. Thank you. Jazakum Allah khairan. I really enjoyed being with you. Wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Jazakum Allah khairan.
Brothers and sisters, tomorrow we have the